Okay, now that we've done some simple editing stuff, I want to make it a little cleaner with some UI stuff so that we could actually control things with a button instead of just putting up a message on the screen that says, hit this key to do something, right? So let's do a basic UI because that will set the groundwork for creating a lot fancier menus and interactions in the future. So what we'd want to do is say add new, user interface, widget blueprint. I'm going to call it main menu 2 because I already have a test one called main menu. So let's go in here and just do it from scratch. This represents our screen here. And the first thing that I usually do is put in a vertical box. And here is where we can search our palette of different items we can put in our UI. And this down here is our hierarchy. So the canvas panel is basically our screen. We can drop a vertical box and child it to the canvas panel. You can see it appears right there. Then we can resize it, either by numbers or just by dragging. This is our anchor right here. So that's anchoring to the top left of our screen, which means this will always be right up in the very top left of our screen. If we move it to here, now this relationship right here, this amount of pixels and this amount of pixels, this padding here, will always be the same in relation to the top left of the screen. Okay, with our vertical panel, let's take now some horizontal panels or horizontal boxes and child them to the vertical box. Now we have a little horizontal box there. We can choose to fill, which fills the entire vertical box. So now our vertical box and our horizontal box are the same size. But let's take another horizontal box, put it in the vertical box as well, child that. And the second one will fill as well, and now they're splitting the difference between the two. Okay, now if we wanted a little padding here, we could do that as well by changing the padding on both horizontal boxes to like 3. Now we have a little bit of padding between the two. Okay, now we could put buttons in there, and we'll just keep on building up our hierarchy. In the horizontal boxes, we'll put buttons. Obviously, we would want those to fill across, right? And I'm not liking the size of any of this, so we could do this. There you go. That's better. And for the horizontal boxes, we're just letting the buttons fill the whole horizontal box, which you can do. You could also add padding to the buttons, right? So they don't fill the whole box. You could add another 3 padding to the button. So now there's vertical box, horizontal box, and then button with all with a little bit of padding in between. Okay, so obviously you can mess with that, and there you can spend a lot of time making it look pretty. We're not going to concentrate on that right now. Let's add also some text to our buttons. We can just put it right there. Text and text. And for now, let's just change this one to say quit, all caps. Okay, there you go. So there's a basic UI with a button and a text, and it's all just hierarchy stuff, and the panel has all the different elements that you can add. Okay, so there's a lot of different elements here. For a basic button like this, this is a very simple setup. Now, this has a event tied to it, this button does. You'll notice the text doesn't, the button does, right? All these events are down here. So we can say onClicked, and then we can do something. Quit game. Compile, save. Okay, and up here you'll see that this is the event graph for the buttons that are in our UI, and we can always go back to the designer here and go back to the visual elements of our design. So graph, designer. Now if we clicked here and did an event for this one, onClicked, it would take us back to the graph automatically, and this would be onClicked for button 1. We could do something else. We're not going to add anything there though. Okay, now, so how do we get this to show up on our screen? Well, we're going to use a different blueprint to reference that entirely. Usually these UIs are tied to the character or our player 0. So if we go into our character module here, which is being possessed by player 0, as we know, or our first player, We can now go into this and edit the blueprint of this so that this player will now see a UI pop up. And you can see I have the basic elements of it here because I was already experimenting with this. So if I just link this up, and we'll talk about everything I did here. If I link this up and compile, and then we'd have to say which menu we want to construct. Compile, save. Okay, so let's see how that works. And remember, this is being triggered by the M button. Okay, so when I play, if I hit M, my UI is constructed and it shows up for my first player, my player one. You can see I now have a mouse active and my menu is active. And I can hit quit and it quits the game. So let's talk about how that's set up. Let's just do it again so that I can walk you through step by step. So first we would search for whatever button we want to use. In this case, let's use escape to bring up our menu. Then we need it to tell the engine to build our UI. So the UI is in our project, but that doesn't mean it's always constructed and showing in our scene. But we are going to construct it by telling it to construct. So let's type in create widget. Okay. So right here we have this node that creates the widget. And we're creating it from the class of main menu 2. That's just selecting which UI we're wanting to create. The owning player, it will only show up to the player that we tell here. So what we do is drag out from here and say get player controller. This is much easier because, you know, we only have one player in the scene, right? So the player controller that we're talking about is player index 0, or the first player in our game, or in our case, the only player in our game. So that is the player that will own this widget that's about to pop up. Now we add it to the viewport. So it's constructed, and then we add it to the viewport of this player that we're talking about here. Add to viewport. And what are we adding to the viewport? We're adding this menu widget that was just created, like that. Now, that would be fine, but let's see what that gives us. If we compile and save, if we hit play, and now we hit escape, ha! We can't use escape because that just automatically closes our game. We don't want that. We could go into the settings and adjust it, but let's just use a different button. So instead of escape, we'll just detach this one here. And use it on my new one. So M is the button we hit for menu. Let's try it real quick. So M. Okay, and you see my menu pops up, but I don't have... I'm still just controlling my character though. So I need to switch control from my character to a mouse control that doesn't move my character around, but now gives me the option to show my pointer up and to click some buttons. So that's the last thing we need to do for this blueprint. Go back into the character here. And remember, I mean, this could be done other ways, but we're doing it in the character because the character is set to receive inputs. So when we hit M, that character knows, okay, construct widget, add to viewport. Okay, so it's just a pretty easy way to handle all of this. So let's set that input up. Also, when we set the input, we want to set it for this particular player. So we'll show how to do that. So set input is the node that we want. Actually, set input mode. Okay, and you have options here. Set input mode, game and UI, game only, or UI only. Okay, for this, we want UI only, because we don't want the character being controlled. So in widget to focus. So here we can tell it which widget we want to the mouse to jump to. And we already have our widget here. It's right there. And we can just say this one. We want the mouse to jump to that one automatically when we hit M. And again, we need to tell it which controller, which player is now using this mode. Which player is going into UI mode? Fortunately, we have that player right here. Okay, if we double click on this, it will give us a reroute node. We can make it a little cleaner here. Let's come down here. Let's come down here so we don't get mixed up. Okay, and the last thing is to show the mouse cursor. Right, we need that. That is specifically set. It is a Boolean. So set show mouse, let's turn off context sensitive. Set show mouse cursor. We'll just set it to yes, checked. And again, we can drag out of our reroute node to here to tell it which one of our players is, again, getting these instructions. So for that player, we're setting show mouse cursor to true so that it should show up. And that's all there is to it for doing the menu. So let's see if it works. Hit play. If I hit M, my menu pops up. You can see my mouse cursor now shows. And here we are. We can hit text block. Nothing will happen. We can hit quit, and the game quits. Okay, so that is a very basic main menu. We can also use that to control other things if we want. So if we go back into here, we could go into the text block event click. So we could view on clicked. Remember, this is the event of clicking that button. And we could say, this, we could turn off our TV and things from here if we wanted. We could print a string that says, hello. Okay, so all that stuff we did with turning on and off TV, we could actually make buttons to turn it on and off here, and we'd run all the blueprints, all the scripting, right off of this button right here. Okay, so that could be a cleaner way to do it. This is a clean way to quit your game. And that's some of the basics of how to do a widget blueprint, and that should help you, help give you some ideas of how you can make some really cool interactions that look sleek and work really smoothly for the user. Last thing is, let's just test this out. Play, M for menu, text block, hello. Okay, there you go.